The findings of our review are summarized in this interactive figure. The idea really is to provide a single overview of quite complex relationships, which can be explored by playing with this figure. To keep it readable, we had to stick to one major simplification. The figure is linear, going from left to right, and no feedbacks or interactions are included. So on the left, the graph shows conditions, or drivers, in blue, that mediate the relative abundance of species with particular trait values, thus influencing the community-weighted mean of a trait in the plant community present. Traits are shown in the middle in orange, and we can explore how they would respond along gradients of these conditions. Blue links indicate positive relationships and red links negative relationships, and link thickness is an estimate of the strength of the relationship. Hovering with the mouse over any one of these links displays a brief description along with an estimate of certainty and some key references. So for example, tissue nitrogen to carbon ratio is expected to increase along increasing levels of nutrient availability, as is often found in wetlands with a high percentage of surface water inflow. The figure then maps out how these traits influence the ecosystem properties and processes in green that combine to generate the three ecosystem services of water flow regulation, greenhouse gas regulation, and water quality regulation in the form of nutrient retention. Clicking on a node highlights everything that is connected to it. This serves to illustrate the complex ecology behind any one of these services, but it also tries to disentangle just that. If we could put actual numbers on these links beyond the three-level estimate given here, it could serve as a template for building mechanistic models of wetland functioning and service delivery. So while we have tried to incorporate the most important traits and processes that enable wetlands to provide these services, the figure is still incomplete. So the data behind the figure is publicly available online, as is the code required to create the figure. This is open to additions and modifications by the scientific community. So you can download the data here, alter it, and update an open version of the figure. We hope that experts from around the world will contribute to complete this picture in a collaborative effort to build a trait-based ecology of wetland vegetation.